Wake up, Roberta. You're getting a text.
Oh, Donna, Obama wants to FaceTime.
Hi, girls.
Hey, Obama, what's up?
Not much. I am sending you a mission? You have $100,000 to
eradicate Ebola. But how will we get there?
Air Force One is waiting outside. Good luck.
See you soon.
We need to get ready.
Live fast, die young, bad girls, do it well. Live fast, die young, bad girls, do it well. Live fast, die young, bad girls, do it well. Live fast, die young, bad girls, do it well. My chain hits my chest when I'm banging on the dashboard. My chain hits my chest when I'm banging on the radio. Get back, get down. Pull me closer if you think you can hang. Hands up, hands high. Don't go screaming if I blow you with a bang.
Wow, my video game skills really paid off. Flying this jet is so easy.
Haha, true that. According to the files Obama sent us, Ebola is a single-stranded RNA virus that leads to a very lethal hemorrhagic fever.
But we already knew that!
But why Sierra Leone?
Well, it's a really poor country and they have really bad sanitation compared to most countries.
So you mean the simple preventive measures, such as an IV or access to a normal medical facility, wouldn't be as effective in Sierra Leone?
That's exactly what I mean. They lack the proper sanitation and education. It's just a terrible situation overall.
They really need our help.
They really need our help.
You know, I was doing some research and I read about how many of the rural villages in Sierra Leone, they have very dangerous burial traditions in where the dead person's body is covered in oil and many people hug and kiss the body, which as we both know can be extremely dangerous since dead bodies of people who died from Ebola contain extremely high concentrations of the disease.
Wow. Another reason why it's such a problem in Sierra Leone is because, as we know, the route of transmission is coming in contact with infected people's body fluids. So in clinics in Sierra Leone where they lack the proper medical care, people are often sharing needles and sharing syringes with infected people, which is, as we both know, very, very dangerous. And these are two big problems that we should fix.
You know what else I heard? That if a man is infected with Ebola and declared cured, Ebola can remain in his semen for up to 9 months.
Wow. I think obviously there's a lack of knowledge and education and understanding surrounding diseases, specifically Ebola, in Sierra Leone, which is why we need to create an education program, but I don't know, education's not always received well by adults who are very set in their ways, set in their traditions. They're not going to receive us coming in there and just telling them all this stuff.
I think what we need to do is target the children. By going through an organization that's already trusted in Sierra Leone, we will be able to teach children basic things about disease prevention and sanitation that they can use later in life to make educated, informed decisions about their health.
That is perfect. So even once we leave, the children will continue to be informed, teach their children, and we will all around cure Ebola.
I say we spend about $50,000 of our budget on that.
I feel that. I feel that $50,000. Yeah, I think that's good. Okay. But then at the same time, I feel a lot of the education can be targeted towards women because there's a lot of stigma around sex in Sierra Leone. It's kind of frowned upon to talk about it. But I've learned about these, I've heard about these like clinics for women, for pregnant women and their children. And I think if we target women in a safe place, it'll be more accepted and we can teach them similar things that we're teaching the children and the fact about the semen and how it can remain and how that's very dangerous to women in a safe place.
Exactly. Methods like handing out condoms really don't work that well.
No.
So I think just educating them in a safe environment is the route to go.
I agree.
All right. Well, how about $10,000 towards that?
I feel that. Again, I feel that amount.
All right. Well, we have $40,000 left. And you know, I found it really interesting what you were saying about those needles.
I know. That's like, so that's why I feel like we should spend the rest of our money towards donating a surplus of sterile medical equipment to all clinics in Sierra Leone and then going and teaching them ourselves, teaching them one-on-one how to use that. So I think overall this plan is good and it will stop Ebola.
Look, there's Sierra Leone.
Oh my god,
we're landing.
We're here. Live fast, die young, bad girls, do it well. Live fast, die young, bad girls, do it well. Live fast, die young, bad girls, do it well. Live fast, die young, bad girls, do it well.
Wow. Long flight.
Long flight.
But we finally made it.
Wow. Should we call Obama and let him know?
Yeah, we should FaceTime him.
Okay. Hey, Obama.
Sup?
Just wanted to let you know that we landed safely in Sierra Leone. Just wanted to tell you that. Thank you so much for the money. We've created a great plan. See you soon. Love
Peace
you.
Up.
Okay, so right. We should probably get to it.
All right, well, I can go meet with the head of the clinics to talk about the $40,000 for needles.
That's good, okay. And then I'll go meet with the teacher, the principal, the head of the schools here, and teach them about our curriculum and our plan for that.
Okay, and then on the way back, I can swing by the women's health clinics and talk to them a little bit about that plan.
All right, sounds good. I'll meet you back here tomorrow.
Okay, sounds good.
Okay, see you later.
Hi, thanks for meeting with me.
No worries, please sit down.
Well,
hi.
As you both know, Ebola is a huge problem in Sierra Leone.
Yes.
So I'm sure you have lots of experience working at a clinic here in the country.
Mm-hmm.
So I work for Obama, and we have been thinking a lot about ways to prevent Ebola. So as you both know, Ebola is contracted through the sharing of bodily fluids.
Of course.
So a major problem is people reusing needles, which have been in contact with bodily fluids of the infected people.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, you know that, of course.
Yes, of course.
So to help deal with this, we're going to ship your clinic a surplus of clean, sterile needles every month to help combat that issue.
God bless you.
Come in.
Hi.
Hi, nice to
meet
you.
Thank you for meeting with me.
Of course.
So I just wanted to talk to you about a special program that me and my coworker and Obama have been creating.
Okay.
So the reason we want to target children is because adults have often taken organizations, they're very set in their ways, so it's sometimes hard, but approaching children will be better because they're open, and this way we can create a whole new generation of informed people. So let me tell you about the curriculum that we've designed. So the curriculum includes basic lessons about hygiene and sanitation so we can eliminate that part of transmitting diseases. It also has basic facts on diseases like how once you die, the disease isn't gone. That doesn't change. It's actually, the concentration goes up. But yeah, the curriculum is very intense. I can tell you about it in a little bit, but what are your thoughts so far?
I think that's such a great idea, and you know, you really picked the right organization to go through.
Hello. Hi, welcome to the Women's Health Clinic of Sierra Leone.
Thank you for having me.
Yeah, nice to meet you.
As you know, I work with Obama, and we're working on helping to eradicate Ebola in Sierra Leone.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the main ways this happens is through sexual contact.
Yes.
As you know. So, we are working on targeting women in a health clinic rather than just handing out condoms and things like that, because in the past that really hasn't worked.
Yeah, not effective.
Due to the stigma surrounding sex here in Sierra Leone.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to implement a $10,000 program in these women's clinics, like the one that you run, to help start a conversation between the clinic workers and women as to the dangers of sexual contact with someone who has had Ebola, because as you know, Ebola can remain in the semen of a man who has even been declared cured of Ebola for up to 9 months afterwards.
Yes, it's a very big problem.
All right, well, I'm glad that I could be of service.
So how'd it go?
It went so well.
Me too.
I think we really eradicated Ebola.
I think that we should call Obama and see what he thinks.
Yeah.
Hey, Obama.
Hi, girls.
We eradicated it, we went around, our plan worked, success!
Yay!
A toast to eradicating Ebola in Sierra Leone.